Hey, Brandon.
Hello, Kat.
Cleaning.
Cleaning, my favorite thing to do.
Yeah, it is. What are you going to clean today?
I'm going to clean the Mazzer Major.
The Mazzer Major, all
It
right.
is a big one, so there's no automatic machine washer. I wish
No,
there was.
yeah. Doesn't fit in the top rack of the dishwasher.
Unfortunately not.
Okay.
A couple things basically we need to get into it first off. This doesn't just pull off, which
Okay.
is nice, so we need to unscrew it from the back.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And we're going to close this off. So you can see this one here actually pushes to close.
Yeah.
One thing we're going to do, unplug it.
Always a good idea. Start there
Yeah.
first. Okay.
From there, it'll actually let me lift this right off, if it's unscrewed. If you still left it plugged in, fret not. I need to figure out a way to do this without.
Oh, fancy.
Fancy. There's a little sensor right here. So if you just spaced out, didn't do that, it still wouldn't let you hurt yourself.
Okay.
Okay, so that's good news. From there, let's get these beans out of there. Handy little top back. Then we can actually screw this right off. So it's got this little coarse and fine side. So to get off, we're gonna go coarse, which is pointing me this way. Also known as clockwise. Just learned that right now.
Or alternatively, gross.
Gross?
That's
Yeah.
what it says on the label.
Is that what it says?
Yeah,
I
doesn't see.
No, it says coarse.
It says gross too, and grasa.
Grossa?
Gross,
For any of our
grasa.
international viewers. All right, so once that's out, we can actually pull that right out.
Okay.
This out of here. This does separate off.
Nice.
Okay, so you can kind of see it was stuck there, but that'll actually separate out. This is a new grinder. We've put a couple pounds through it, but there's not a lot through it.
Okay.
Normally, you would want to separate that out because it's going to be grimy and nasty in between here.
Okay, and so that's what another area you'd want to clean.
Yep, and chances are yours is going to come out the way mine just did. It's going to come out looking like that.
Okay.
So just keep in mind there's nothing special. Just pull it.
Okay.
From there, we can actually get down inside of here. Grab a little brush. I think I got a little mini brush right here too. Really, what we're just trying to do right now is just loosen all that stuff. I mean, you can see I vacuumed it out earlier, but a lot of this stuff is sticky. There's a lot of oils in espresso, so it just starts sticking down inside of these burrs. I really like to try to get this section right there out of there because this is where you'll get a lot of buildup.
Okay.
And
Do
a
you
lot
want
of
to remove the bottom burr?
No, at this point here, not really. You can. So I don't have any issues doing that.
Okay.
And if you want, just for the purpose of this video, we can actually do that. So if I go here. So if you want to get this off, one of the hard parts is that spins.
Yeah.
Take another flathead screwdriver, just stick it right there, and then that's going to bind against that collar, and that's going
Okay.
to allow me to twist these.
Now, it's not a issue taking these apart regularly as long as you are gentle with the screws,
As
right?
long as you're careful, that is the
Okay.
only thing. It's actually a very good thing to take these out regularly for cleaning. But if you are not very good with the screwdriver and you strip these screws out, you are going to make a service tech very unhappy.
Yeah.
These are one of the hardest screws on these machines when you strip that piece out to actually get.
So, if you're concerned about that, how frequently should you do this?
If you are that concerned about it, you should be replacing these burrs anyways once a year.
Okay.
So, once a year.
Okay, got it.
if you can, from a cleaning standpoint, get these out of here without being too hard on those screws.
Sorry, I'm all over the grill.
That's okay. I'm used to it by now. We can actually get that out. So, here's why I want to get this out. Look at that.
Yeah, so that was underneath the burr.
Yep, that was
Okay.
underneath the burr. That sits right there. It makes its way in from here. It's not imperative. This would not be your A reason for yanking these things out.
Okay.
So if you are just very unstable and you can't hold it flat and you really think you're going to strip it, not worth the effort to do it.
Got it.
If you are stable, you can see it was not very hard.
And are you talking physically versus mentally stable?
Well,
Yes.
I've got the first part down. So from
Okay.
inside there, we can actually do that. I'd actually just wipe that off, but I think I can get here. See how even on this collar that was holding it, see how much buildup is in there?
I can't because your
Our
hand
fingers
was in
right
the
there.
way.
How about
Yeah.
this? See how
Okay.
much buildup is just right there?
Yeah.
It's all that little stuff that we really want to get out of there.
Okay. So you kind of take a brush or some kind of implement down in there, and then you can vacuum it and
Yep.
clean real
Anything to
well.
loosen it?
obviously we've only just put a few pounds of coffee through this. If this was a high production machine, there'd probably be quite a bit underneath there.
Quite a bit underneath there.
And there could probably be very cemented too from oils,
yep.
Correct?
Yep.
Okay.
So oil and all the heat. You got to remember, inside this chamber, it actually gets really, really hot.
Okay.
So when you're using this 500 drinks a day, just yeah. going and going, it's turning it into a cement. You're also going to have oil all the way up and down this chamber.
So it might not be a brush job. You might need to use some like dental, like those little pick tools or something yep. to gently yep. work that stuff away.
And once I'm open like this, there's really no hazard to anything that I'm doing in here. So okay. I mean, again, you can take a little rag like that, especially if you have oils that are built up all through mm-hmm. there. You can do that. This is no one's is going to look this nice unless it's yeah. brand new. But yeah, that's what you want to, that's really what we're aiming for. We want to get all that stuff that you saw out
of it. Do I have to worry anything about these little screw chambers here or the spring chambers?
Talking
about these? Do I need to clean anything in there or they don't get anything in there? Okay.
Nah. They, if you want to, you could grease it just to make sure it's still springy. What that it does is it's giving you tension action on this collar.
Yeah.
So right now you can see if I were to just screw this on here like that, see how just easy it is to spin it around?
Yeah.
Well, once I get it on, it just spins and spins and spins. Without this, that's what that tension's for. So the reason it's hard is these things that are pushing back up to you.
Now, do I worry about taking my top burr off and cleaning? Is that as much of a concern as the bottom burr?
This is actually a little bit less of a concern, mainly because this is harder.
Okay.
So this one's pretty easy to get out. Mm-hmm. I would be more fearful of you doing this one only because it's
you could
really
strip
hard.
It more easily.
Yeah.
Okay.
It doesn't really give you a great place to brace it like with a vice grip. You'll end up bending the collar.
Yeah.
So this is very much... You have to have your hand nice and flat. Now, right there, you can see mine was pretty easy to do.
Yeah.
However, yours is going to be stuck.
Because you've been using it a lot.
I've been using it a lot.
Okay.
So you're going to watch this video and be like, gosh, he's strong. But really, I'm just cheating because it's new.
Yeah, but you are pretty strong.
Okay,
so now we've got, so we want to clean that burr off before we place it down again with a brush. And
yep. Same thing from here. You don't even really got to be gentle. Just trying to get the, anything
get it
out of
done.
There. Yeah.
Okay, so after I replace the burrs in there, what's my next step?
So the only other thing really, once we're open like this, we've mm-hmm. got a couple different things we want to do. There's that little tiny chamber that's inside here.
Yeah.
Now, that's a little hard to get to, but you can, especially once this burrs out, it's a lot easier.
Okay.
But what we can do is we can take this off as well.
So, and that's just the little guide, the grounds guide?
Yep. This is just a little guide that when we're spraying, it forces that espresso to go down.
Okay.
A lot of people... probably don't even have one.
They've taken it off at some point.
They've taken it off, or maybe they've bought it used and whoever it was before took it off. So they're watching this video right now going, that's not mine.
Yeah, exactly.
I can't tell you how many shops I go into where this is actually already gone.
Okay.
Part of it, I think, is when someone takes it off, it takes a little bit of patience to put it back on.
Yeah.
And they finally are like,
who cares? Or they accidentally strip a screw at some point.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay.
And so really, if that was gone, all that would happen is we would just have a lot more buildup up here. But so you can see this chamber mm-hmm. that's going right through there. You can see my finger come through.
Yeah.
Ours is, again, it's pretty clean. If yours is old and been used for quite a while, mm-hmm. there's going to be a lot of buildup because the more oils we get inside there, the more it sticks, the more it solidifies. I've seen this at a lot of places, this will restrict your flow. This will slow you down. If this hole is not as big as it is and it's caked up there and you only have 30% of a, it's like an artery.
Exit, yeah.
It's going to slow down how much you can actually get through there.
So I clean down in there, want to vacuum that out real well.
Yep. I like to, again, before you just vacuum, just take a little paintbrush, anything mm-hmm. like that, just to loosen everything. If we can get it down to the bottom, then it's nice and easy just to vacuum out of there.
Okay. And are you going to be able to get the vacuum in the little chamber? Or?
No, well, that chamber hopefully is all basically out. You can do that.
Okay.
Hopefully, if you did your job with the screwdriver, basically, that chamber should mostly be empty.
Clear. Okay.
So it's nice and loose to actually pull that out.
And then we have coffee in our hopper over there, but you could put that back into the coffee bag or somewhere safe.
Yep.
And you could wash that guy out too, right?
Because
that's the best sort of thing to, because you don't want it to have, you want it to be clear.
Exactly.
Right.
You want it to look the way it looks right now. This one normally would require a bit of a helping hand if you have it.
But I don't help.
But I'm talented. So we can actually just go right back into it, just mm-hmm. like that.
And then you can wash that guy out real well.
Yep, and then I can actually just take this apart, wash it. You can see again, just a little bit of stuff.
Yeah.
It's brand new. Most people, again, are probably looking at this right now going, no, mine's brown.
Yeah, exactly.
Yours is not brown. Yours is that color.
Cool.
See-through.
All right, so then it's just about getting it back together again. So yep, anything else I need to think about?
No, that's really going to get the whole process clean. So we're out, again, really it's, you want yours looking like this.
Yeah.
This is a new one. And the reason we do it new is that people can kind of see what a new one looks like.
Yeah.
Ideally, if it looks like this, if it's clean, if it's that color,
then you're a happy camper.
Then you're a happy camper. And also, again, you're not grinding with nastiness into your espresso, which has ended up in your customer's drinks.
Nobody likes nastiness.
No one.
Only sweetness. Thanks, Brandon.
Thanks, Kat.